Anybody out there?
And now, live from Manchester.
Hello to you all from the north.
Oof, what's she doing?
What's this? I've got the, we just happened to have here.
That's Santa's grotto in here. He's got loads of... Oh.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Yeah,
see, that's the... Shut up, you bastard.
Yeah, it's not Christmas, though. Whereas it is Easter. Yeah. You see, you've actually got too many gimmicks, Mark, if you don't mind me saying.
You think so?
Yeah. I can do that on my organ.
Why? Do you think there's a return to the basics in show business?
Well, I just
shut
think...
Shut up.
Yeah, shut up. I think it's just... Look, it's quarter past ten. You know, I think you're a bit too frenetic. I think you should be winding down.
Right.
Lots of these... I know you play to a lot of students, but they'll be putting the pens away in the pencil case now.
Right.
They'll have finished the studies. They'll be making themselves a milky drink.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, it's not just old people who like to wind down. Young people do as well.
Right.
So maybe you should play Judy Zook. Stay with me till dawn, something like that.
What a good idea.
But you won't, you'll play something frenetic, won't you?
I bet. Now, that's just where you're wrong.
Oh.
That's just where you're wrong. Listen to this, the Cardigans. You see, now that's. Does that sound.
Sounds very promising.
Right.
Listen, Mark.
What?
Can I go and check my car?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Because I've left it in a very badly lit area.
Right.
And I could kick myself and left a Chris Rea tape on the dashboard.
Mm.
You know, that will go mountain.
It will. I mean, they go like wildfire around here, those do.
Do they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd get out there and get your crook lock secured.
Well, it is.
Right.
But the Chris Rea tape isn't, you know, it's just resting on the dashboard.
I'd go and sort that, John, if I was you.
Right. But have you finished with me? Or do you want me to come back and play some numbers?
Yeah, we'll play some numbers later on, shall we?
Later on, yeah.
I think that'd be good.
All right. I'll see you in a while.
Fine. Okay.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Right, bye-bye. Right, John. Mark Kermode.
I'm having a depressing showbiz moment because we were out in the control box. And I said, they said, do you know John? And I said, oh, yeah, well, you know, we've done gigs together and everything. And I come in and I said, all right, John, how's it going? And he goes, sorry.
Well.
I've never seen him before,
then. He's never seen me before in my life, so.
He's a showbiz legend, though. I mean, you know, he doesn't remember people
we
like
we warmed up for him.
Did you?
Yeah.
Well, very good.
Some crisps or anything like that.
No, a tracker bar.
Tracker bar.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Thanks a lot. Yeah, okay. Yeah, right. Well, two records which really indicate how far Brian Wilson came between 1964 and 66. The first one from 66 and the classic album Pet Sounds, I Know There's an Answer. And then one he co-wrote before that from 1964, which was Dead Man's Curve by Jan and Dean. And sort of a fantastic recipe, really. Sun, sea, surf and a fatal automobile accident. And it was co-written by Brian Wilson and the DJ, Roger Christian, who was actually arrested for curb crawling, recording the car effects for that song. And Jan Berry very nearly made the song his sort of personal epitaph when he shortly after ran his Corvette into a post. But his partner, Dean Torrance, loyally supported him by hiring another bloke straight away and carrying on regardless. There was an advert in the paper. Wanted bloke called Jan to form surf duo. Call Venice Beach 3752 and ask for Dean. John Shuttleworth is with us tonight. Is that the kind of music you like? Sort of something with a bit of...
Yes, nice harp there, wasn't there?
Well,
number 38, isn't it?
Was it? Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah,
that.
It is, isn't it?
That's very nice, yeah. But I mean, is that, do you think that's kind of distasteful to put a fatal automobile smash into a pop song?
Yes, but a near fatal crash would be all right.
Well, it would, really.
Because I've written a song about incident on the Snake Pass.
Have you?
I had a Ford Anglia.
Right.
At the time, so back in the 70s.
Yes.
Mark, when you were a little lad.
Indeed.
Probably had a fairy cycle at the time.
A what?
Did you have a fairy cycle?
A fairy
or
cycle?
A chipper, something like that.
A chipper?
Anyway,
it was the chipper, the little chopper?
That's right, it was.
Right.
I had a Ford Anglia.
Right.
And I was coming back from Manchester, which is where we are now.
Yes.
On Snake Pass.
I was on the Snake Pass the other night with Lard.
Were you?
Mm. Yeah, not in the biblical sense. Pardon?
You're slipping all over the place then.
Yeah, not in the biblical sense. Not in the Caligula sense.
I see. Oh, you're being smutty.
Have you seen Caligula?
You know,
we're not.
Terrible.
We're discussing high art.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well,
as opposed to
listen,
high peak.
Shut up, Mark.
Right.
I'm telling you. Look, I was had a collision with an articulated lorry on the Snake Pass. Hence the title. Yeah. Do you want to hear it then?
No.
No.
Yeah, I'm joking. That's just showbiz joshing with you.
Well,
John.
You're going to hear it whether you like it or not.
Right.
It's a very strong song. Here we go. Normally, when I perform this, I have lots of little snakes and toys, you know, because that can be quite boring to look at visually, you know.
Doesn't matter on the radio.
Driving home on the snake pass all alone. That's not quite true. I was in the company of Radio 2. And Brian Matthew is telling me, take care, the roads are icy. It's a bit slow, isn't it? Hang on. A bit faster. John, you're a fool. Oh, what a fool. You thought you were cool, but you were a fool. Humming a refrain, I was oblivious to the wind and rain. Headlights in the night, I didn't see them till it was too late. Oh, Brian Matthew, you were right. I should have taken more care that night. I was driving too fast. I was driving far too fast. Who do you think you are, Stirling Moss? No, you're not, as you found to your cost. I should have seen it coming. I really should. And it comes back to me as clear as day. Those lights coming towards me. No, look out. Look out. Ooh, trapped in a car. I was trapped in a car. Trapped in a car. Trapped in a car. Fortunately, my injuries were only superficial. Having said that, to me, they were very real. I won't do it again. Not on purpose, anyway. No, look out. Yeah.
Wow, it's fantastic. And I think that, you know, there's a lesson there in showbiz, because how you use the keyboard there to illustrate certain dramatic parts of the story.
Yeah.
I thought it was fantastic.
Did you?
Yeah.
What, you like the car?
Yeah.
Car on.
That was great. It really was.
Thank you very much, Mark. Thank you.
So do you write all the time? I mean, when you're out on the road doing some of your show business concerts, like the Gatehouse Stafford, or the Assembly Rooms Derby the night after, or Swindon Arts Centre, or the Hull Truck Theatre in Hull.
Yeah.
Could be in Truck. On the 19th. Oh. You know, when you're doing things like that, do you write concept pieces on the road?
Yes, I do. You know, I might suddenly be missing my wife or something. You know, so I write a little song about missing my wife. And it might go something like this, you know. Oh, you can pulse the air to this one, Mark. Mary, I am missing you, missing you, missing you. Wishing to be kissing you, but unfortunately I can't. Mary, I am missing you, missing you, missing you. Wishing to be kissing you, but you visited a poorly aunt. Aunt, aunt, you know.
Oh, it's good, and it's got a good ending, hasn't it?
Do you like that?
Yeah.
You see, my agent, Ken Worthington, he says that's weak. He says it's not commercial.
Is it?
The point is, I know some people who love that one.
I like
some friends of ours, Mr. and Mrs. Whittaker, they love that. You know, she's a lab technician. Mm. So it's just a question of taste, isn't it?
Absolutely, absolutely.
I think it's strong.
I noticed you've got an embroidered anti-Macassar on the front of your keyboard there.
I thought it was anti-Macassar.
Hey? Well, Castor.
What is it?
Anti-Macassar.
Oh.
Isn't it? Casters or something like Shepherd's Mini Casters that you put on the bottom of a recalcitrant settee that won't shift,
He's got lots of big words, hasn't he?
Oh, what?
But listen, it covers up a word. Do you know what word it covers up?
Bollocks.
Oh, it doesn't.
No, it doesn't. No.
Chicken played a solo then. No, it covers up Yamaha.
Yes.
Because Yamaha gave me this organ, you see.
Right.
In return for me saying Yamaha lots of times. But I can't do that now, Mark, because they're the Japs, aren't they? You know. And yes, they had a terrible time with Kobe recently, but still they're killing the whales, you know, and that's not on.
Absolutely.
Norway are doing it as well. But they've got an excuse, haven't they?
Yeah.
They're coming last on Eurovision.
Yeah, they are.
They need a scapegoat.
Well, and it's the last time I buy a Norwegian organ, I tell you. Definitely.
Yeah. It is, really. Well, you see, I've thought about this, Mark. Yeah. They shouldn't be attacking marine life, should they?
Absolutely.
Really. Yeah. You know, they should be harpooning the songwriters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Hey, what about this one? I wrote this one the other day. He goes, I'm lying, I wrote it last summer because my son Darren, he was killing honeybees in the bay window.
Right.
And he thought they were jaspers, you know. They weren't, they were honeybees. He goes, oh, that's
what's a jasper?
A jasper, it's a wasp.
Oh, right.
Where have you been?
I thought it was a biscuit.
Oh, no. Oh, it's a biscuit as well, very nice biscuit.
Yeah.
No, it's a wasp. He goes, go down. Very clever lyric, this, Mark. Listen. That's it, jingle a bell. Go down on... Go down on your knee to the honeybee, for she is very nice. Before you kill her with a rolled-up mirror, Think twice. How will that bee's mother feel when she finds out her child is a ghost? Kill the bee, and ultimately, you'll have nothing to spread on your toast.
Great. Yeah. The ecologically sound John Shuttleworth. More from him later.
Last week's winners. Last I've also decided winners. One thing that will go in the winner's bag this week as well.
Have we?
I've decided that, yeah.
What is it?
Oh, copies of this. I said there's this magazine, Hidden Detail, that comes out of Lancashire. It's got that very long article about what the different versions are. We'll chuck in three copies of that, so even though you can't see the film, you can know what the difference between the Dutch version and the English version are. So we will buy them with our own good money.
And that's a big prize in your book, is it?
We couldn't get the videos.
No, I'm not saying we could.
It's a legal thing.
Yeah, fine. All right. I'm sure it's a good fanzine.
It's a good fanzine.
It doesn't exactly rip your head off, does it?
Out soon.
Mm. Good. All right, then. Fine.
Look, calm down, for goodness sake.
John Shuttleworth is with us tonight, and...
Calm down. Just into the waves. Oh, sorry, it's fog on. Don't want that one.
Right, John Shuttleworth, and he's in the middle of this sellout kick-bossy rock and roll tour, continuing on, what day? Oh, week on, no, day after tomorrow at the Gatehouse, Stafford, yeah. Yes. Following that, the Assembly Rooms Derby, Swindon Arts Centre, Hull Truck Theatre, on 24th, the Gate Ghoul, the 20th...
Yeah.
What?
Ghoul.
Yeah.
Liverpool Festival, get towards the East Coast, isn't it, Ghoul?
I don't know, I've never been to Ghoul, funnily enough. The 25th, Colchester Arts Centre, 30th, York Arts Centre, into April, 1st, the Live Theatre, Newcastle, and the 4th, South Holland Centre, Spalding. So that's the whole country covered, isn't it?
It is, really.
I would have said. Right.
Yeah, and get a bag of potatoes to take home with me at the end of the tour.
Lovely. Very nice. Right. Yeah.
What?
What do you want me to say? Some tortuous introduction. So what are you going to do for your last number for us tonight, John?
Well, I think, you know, as I've said, I think it's a bit too jaunty, this show. For late night listening. Gee, you should be winding down now.
Mm.
And I want to finish with a song that's it is a bit sad.
Yeah.
It's all about, I wrote it after I'd attended a funeral of an hang glider pilot called Eric Blackburn.
Yeah. No
you
relation.
You don't know him, but Ken knows him, you know.
Yeah.
And what's that light come on for?
That.
Blimey, what's that?
It comes in when you mention hang glider pilot.
Right, anyway.
Yeah, it's a warning light at Radio 1. That light comes on whenever the word Blackburn.
Blackburn. Right, I won't mention that then. Well, it wasn't in Blackburn, it was near Athersage on Burbage Moors, you know.
Oh, wow.
And it was coming into land.
It's gone off now, you see. And so he said there's nothing to do with Blackburn, it's gone off.
A gust of wind took him off at an angle.
Yeah.
It's coming into land, he said, get the Volvo, Val. Those are the last words to his wife, apparently. Because this gust of wind, don't laugh at that, you sicko. Sicko, isn't he? He got his Wellington caught in a fern, took him off at an angle into a rock where he crashed. Yeah. And died as a result of his injuries. Now, I attended that funeral.
Mm-hmm.
I came home to find my son down very poorly. On the sofa, he had tonsillitis. He was seeing little creatures on the ceiling, like you do when you got a fever, you know. Now, at that time, though, we had a caravan parked hard up against the bay window of the lounge.
Oh, dear.
So, there was very little natural daylight coming in. It was like a tomb, you know, even on a bright, sunny day. Anyway, I was feeling very down, and I wrote a song about it, which... still maintain and work very well in a summer pageant, possibly a force of review show, something like that.
Yeah,
you know.
Definitely, yeah.
It's from my son, Darren, anyway. Now, there is a guitar solo.
Right.
Which you can join in on, Mark.
Right.
Well, I've got a Bon Tempi, haven't you?
I've got a Bon Tempi.
Which sounds like a slide projector. Don't it? Listen to that.
There it goes.
Does it not do slides?
Well, no.
Yeah, it's rubbish, that, isn't it?
Yeah, or I've got this.
Hasn't got MIDI. Oh, haven't got headphones. Where's my headphones? That lad's got them. Come here.
That lad's got them.
That's nice. Right, let's go.
So what do you prefer, Bon Tempi or modulator?
Bit of both.
Right,
bit of,
okay.
But be sensitive with it, Mark.
Well, tell
can
me
you,
when
can
it...
Can you switch it off? It's a fucking racket. Hang on. It's for me son, Darren, this one.
Right, okay, lovely.
I will attend you when you're very ill. Plump the pillows beneath your head. I'll undertake... your burial. Oh, my wife Mary will, if I'm already dead. Hush now, my child, lie you very still. Eat your tomato soup and soft white bread. For I'll undertake your burial. Oh, my wife Mary will, if I'm already dead. Oh, 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 oh. watch this bit, it goes, oh, 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 here we go. That'll rock you now. That's it.
Tune up!
It's you.
I'll go back to this then.
Here we go. Look for it. Yes. From a father to a son. What did you think of that, then?
Crap. No, it was good, wasn't it? I thought we...
Something was happening, wasn't it?
I thought it was, yeah.
Something was evolving there.
Just keep talking while I seamlessly change this record, because the one I've got is too long. Right.
Well, I could perhaps play you a song I wrote called Paul.
Oh, right.
Goes, Paul, Paul, your love is like a shawl. can you hear a call? It's about St. Paul. You know, I wrote it for the children's thing in the pageant. They didn't use it in the end.
Right, funny that,
but,
eh?
Like a roundelay. I can't remember it now, Mark.
Right.
I've lost it.
Okay, well, I'm going to play this tune now. Best of luck with the rest of your tour.
Thank you very much.
And, well, I'm going to play this tune now.
See you again.
Best of luck with the rest of your tour.
You've just said that. What do you want me to do?
I'm going
to
play this tune now.
What?
This one.
Go on, then.
Best of luck with the rest of your tour.
Thank you, Mark.
Mark Radcliffe, missing you already.